So now we have our formal grammar for JavaScript, and previously we had a formal grammar for HTML. But there's a slight difference between the creative work of making up the grammar, thinking of the right one, designing your own language, making the new Esperanto, and checking utterances to see if they're valid. For example, we really want to accept expressions like 1 plus 2 plus 3, but we really want to reject random sequences of tokens like this 1 plus 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 close parenthesis 3. This makes us super sad. It's not immediately clear how you check to see if an utterance is in a grammar. We can do it in our heads, but how would we write a computer program to do it? Remember, we're making a web browser, and we want to render as much valid HTML and JavaScript as we can, but web designers sometimes make errors, and we're going to need to know how to detect that. So this decision, is it in my formal language or is it not, am I super happy or am I super sad, is something that we're going to need our web browser, a computer program, to do. So we're going to need some sort of automated technique. One approach, and this approach is super slow. We're talking snail speed here. Actually, I think I may claim this doodle is so good that I do not even need to label it. We all just know it's a snail. One approach would be to enumerate all strings in the language of the grammar, and then just check to see if yours is in there. If it is, you win. If not, your string must have been invalid. Unfortunately, we mentioned earlier that often a finite grammar has an infinite number of strings, so spending an infinite amount of time to enumerate them all is probably not feasible, but let's try it anyway. So we're going to try this approach first, even though we have some intuition that it's not going to work out. And the reasons are, one, it's instructive to see why we need more complicated parsing techniques later, but also because it gives us a chance to learn a little bit more about Python and some cool programming techniques that will help you in this class and later on. So here are my power tools. This is a hammer, which I guess is technically not a power tool, but it's possible for me to dry it. And this is my, let's say, circular saw. Could also be an unhappy squid. This one definitely needs a label. Let's imagine, circular saw. So I'm going to introduce you to a new type of expression in Python, Lambda, which is another way of defining functions. Here I've written Python code to make a function add2 of x, which returns x plus 2. You can put a Python function like this all on one line, as long as it fits. And if I write add2 of 2, I expect to get 4 out. Here I've written something apparently completely different. I'm assigning to the variable mystery the result of, a Lambda expression. So here, the word lambda is fixed, it's a terminal, and then you list some number of arguments, and then you have a colon, and then here you can put any expression you like. If I call mystery 3, I'm going to get out a 5, because the interpretation of this is that lambda has made a function that takes x as its argument and returns x plus 2. So we just take this 3 and we substitute it in for x, 3 plus 2 is 5, 5 is what we get out. So mystery and add 2 are in fact the same. But now I can do cute things like saying Pele gets mystery, and then if I write Pele of 4, I'm going to get 6. So I can make up functions with this lambda expression and then assign them around. Pele was a Brazilian footballer, one of the best of all times. Lambda means make me a function, and it's very popular in a paradigm of programming known as functional programming. Functional programming sometimes contrasts with object-oriented programming and imperative programming. You'll get a chance to learn about those in other classes. Lambda means make me a function. It's a lot like def.